finally stopped using the nylon slip lead leash and bought a new prong collar that you recommended. Been watching all your prong collar training videos, and it's worked out great. Our walks
awesome.
Are thumbs up.
Awesome. I think it's really important to understand that, yes, a lot of dog trainers can be, they could work on slip leads, but this is the thing. Man, the prong collar is one of the best tools out there as well. Next. We're live. Boom! We've had really spotty internet. We're now in Nevada, which is north of San Francisco, south of Petaluma, where our seminar is this weekend. And it is, what day of the week is today? Wednesday.
What's going on here?
Wednesday night. Hello, everybody. How are you doing tonight? We got in late last night. We got in around 11 p.m. and then we stopped at a local Safeway to get some food.
Are we live right now?
Yeah, we're live.
Because mine's saying waiting for salt. So, like, what's the latency on this thing?
I don't know, but we're live. I think we're live. Mine says live. So, we're just going to do a show like we're live. So, hi, everybody. How are you doing? Yep, we're live. Good morning, Jeff and Joelle and everyone in the chat. So, let me just turn the volume down.
See, an error occurred. What's going on?
I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell you at all. Give me a couple of seconds here to get back on buffering. Yeah. So, we might not be able to do the show. Mm-hmm. Did this happen last time we were here?
Are we live?
Okay. Okay, now we can know you do not need to pay to play. Some people just like to do that just to throw an extra cash away for all the years of help that we've been giving them. The Wi-Fi that we are on right now has been going on and off all day. So if we get disconnected,
another buffer.
So we might not be able to do the show. Mm. We might not be able to do the show. But then what are we gonna do? We can't do a show a week. Yeah. Okay. All right, guys. If we're going to keep buffering, this is not going to be good for anybody.
No,
it's not going to be good for anybody. So if you want to just type in, you know, sorry, guys, it looks like we don't have a good connection. And we even lowered the quality of the stream down to the lowest quality stream we can get. So I'm not quite sure what we're going to be able to do.
Are you on the Wi-Fi here? Yeah, what if I jump off the Wi-Fi?
Okay. I'll try that.
I think Diane says we're good now.
Okay,
we'll try it.
We'll keep trying it. Do the show. Good now. We'll try. We'll do our best. How's that? We'll do our best. Okay. So let's go.
All right. Michelle. My husband wants to know why one of our dogs pins him down and obsessively licks his face and ears, awaiting your snarky reply.
The husband? Because that's a game for your dog. There's no snarky reply. That's just a game. That's what dogs do. So you're playing with a dog like another dog would. That's what that is. No snarkiness involved. Next.
Britt, I was able to talk to a person who asked how old my shepherd was. When I told him, he said he was small. Well, his dog's barking at the gate, and one being shepherd. Today on our walk, I walked up training in front of small kids. She downed multiple times
awesome.
In front of kids.
Awesome.
She was beautiful.
Good. Great to have it. Yeah. Uma was a very small shepherd. She was a very, very small shepherd. It's funny because I saw the litter and the rest of the litter looked like larger shepherds, but she looked totally different than any of the other dogs. Probably one of the best dogs that I had. Next.
Gretchen, I can't stay, but Jeff, you had all day and you still left me on red. Or Joelle. I never know who I'm talking to. No excuses. Honestly, it might have been me. I'm so guilty of leaving people on red. I'm like, oh, I'll get back to that. I'll get like a text from somebody or like a work thing I gotta do. And then I never.
Red on what?
Instagram.
Yeah, don't take it personally, guys. Don't take it personally. We're getting hundreds and hundreds of messages a day. And then we're also producing content. And we also had to go grocery shopping. And we went to the gym. And we also are dealing with a lot of other things. And we're running the company back in Providence. So I think considerably we're one of the few dog training companies that actually respond to people and give.
And it's us.
So I think we're doing pretty good. Next.
Cassie, 9-week-old golden doodle. He's too young for prong. I'm using slip on him now. What punishment do I use when he nips, bites my 5-year-old son?
That would be a pretty firm one. I would use the bonker. How old is the dog?
9 weeks.
9 weeks old. Just say no and then bonk. knowing the bonk. The bonker, it's a wrapped up towel. It's important that people, I understand there's a lot of negativity going on out there right now, but it actually is one of the best ways to put an inhibitor into the dog. Always say no first, then bonk. The dog will not like have a bad relationship with your son. If this keeps up, you'll be getting rid of the dog, and then your son will just hate the dog. Next.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and everyone in the chat.
Hey, Melissa, how are you?
Bob, after learning an obedience command and then a refusal because of distraction, how would you correct?
All depends on how many repetitions you've done on the obedience command. So most people come to the show, or they see the seminars is how we stop unwanted behaviors. But what they're not seeing is the hundreds and hundreds of times that we use a clicker with food, the dog's daily food, to train the behavior. So what we're doing is we're stopping an unwanted behavior is one thing. That's usually one and done. But to train the behavior, what you're doing is you're doing hundreds. So I don't know how many times you've actually taking the dog through the stages of the behavior and then done distraction training with the dog. So I don't know how many of those you've done. So you want to probably do 3, 4, sometimes 500 repetitions before you get up to the no, which would be the punisher for not holding command. Next.
Dark Warrior, any tips on working with a fearful pit bull? He has no interest in food or toys.
So what you can do is, all you have left is compulsion. Compulsion is force. You know, a lot of people will say, you shouldn't be using force for a dog. It's like, that's under the assumption that it's a food-driven dog, or a toy-driven dog, or a verbal praise-driven dog. But what happens when it's not? Well, then what they'll say is build a better relationship, saying, I can't until I start working the dog. So what we do is we use, what's going to work today? It's time to work. And then with that work comes the relationship. Next.
Mm-hmm. Mad Dog. Oh, already read that. Oh, no, just kidding. What's up? My first time on here. Fellow trainer from San Diego or South Dakota? SD, which one?
Could be San Diego or South Dakota.
Have you announced the dates that you will be out here?
So if it is Ramona, San Diego, December 5th and 6th. For South Dakota, I don't think we're doing in 2020. Next. We're going to be North Dakota, though, right?
Yeah.
We're going to be North Dakota.
That's not that close, though.
I know it's a different state, but San Diego, it looks like we'll be going to be doing Ramona, California, December 5th and 6th. Next.
Bob, runt of the litter, Jeff. They can be amazing, as you found out.
Mm-hmm.
Next. Cassandra.
Yep.
Hey, guys, I recently corrected my dog on high mid-reaction. He was rushed by another dog recently and has gone backwards in his reactivity.
Mm-hmm.
And he redirected on me, but stopped when he realized it was me. Is redirection common? What did I do wrong? He's never redirected before.
So usually, redirection is very common, especially when you're stopping an unwanted behavior. And what it is they have to take their energy and put it somewhere. I know redirection is a choice because you have two handlers in the same situation. The dog redirects on one handler and doesn't redirect on the other handler. Also, sometimes if your timing is late, that's why we correct the first sign of obedience. I'm sorry, the first sign that the dog's going to do something wrong, so the dog doesn't have a time to go into drive. Next.
Lily, any idea when or if Britt will be releasing new trick training videos on cool dog tricks?
She is so busy right now at the training center. I've got 4 trainers at the training center. I'm actually not training dogs at the training center. I'm on the road training all the time. So there's nothing out there right now. Maybe we can start having her do one or two at a time. Next.
Mad Dog said, by SD, I meant San Diego.
Got it.
I was right the first time.
Got it. So Ramona, December 5th and 6th, but nothing is concrete until the contract is signed. Next.
Diane, my dog only wants to play ball out in the snow, and I don't. What do I do?
Jeez.
That's always fun.
That's also hard because the snow is a little bit deep.
I can't chuck it with my guys in the snow.
It'll go in there, and if they don't have good hunt drive, they're like, where's the ball? And I'm
You know what I find is they anticipate the bounce off.
Yes.
So they don't run. They run over too far.
Texas famous for that.
It's so annoying.
Yes, it's Texas famous for that. So try to find something else your dog likes. Like, I don't know. Something else.
Something else next. Todd, a friend just got 11-week-old Malinois, and the puppy is very aggressive toward other dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Is it fear-based?
No, probably not. It's probably because it's an 11-week-old puppy. I suggest, first of all, a Malinois historically is not a pet dog. I suggest your friend find a trainer that probably in the sport dog world that works with Malinois. It's a special breed of dog. It's historically not geared towards the family at all. And in order to be the most successful. Next.
T.I., hello, Jeff. Help, please. My one-year-old beagle runs the block every time he gets a chance and not coming back even if I call him.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta chase him every time.
Okay. Let me make a suggestion. Keep your dog on a leash and don't let go. Do not let your dog off leash. Teach your dog thresholds, but also remote collar train your dog for recall. You actually have to train the dog to come back. And you can have a dog that also will blow through even the best training. I mean, all you have to do is go to YouTube and queue up a dog training competition. These are highly trained dogs, and they make mistakes all the time. So you have to train your dog to not only recall, but recall underneath high distractions, and then also recall and drive. Next.
Cassie, puppy keeps biting at his back legs. Vet says she doesn't think it's allergies or an infection. Is this normal, and how do I keep it from becoming an obsessive behavior?
So then you can, believe it or not, you would have to apply a punisher. Anything you want to stop, you have to apply a punisher. So with a punisher, it's, you're not yelling, you're not screaming, you're not upset, you're not mad. But if you said no and bonk, the dog would stop doing it. We've seen it numerous times. We've stopped it numerous times. Next.
Michelle, I'm dealing with some dominance issues in the pack. Young unaltered male has started marking on my female.
Mm-hmm.
He got bonked already. I'm waiting for the act of God correction timing I need.
Yep, that's what you're going to have to do. I'm glad you know how to figure that out. Next.
Madeline, my dog gets super excited when he sees a leash for walks, barking, yipping, hopping, but as soon as I look at him to put it on, he sits and quiets down. How am I supposed to get a calm dog before I walk?
You can actually put a slip lead on the dog and then let it drag the slip lead around and then role play what it's supposed to look like. Role play what it's supposed to look like. Believe it or not, you can also use a remote collar, but also, again, a bonker. I mean, that's why we love the bonker, guys, and that's why there's so many people. This is the thing. I'm a pet dog trainer. I'm helping families solve problems every single day. Like, we just posted up another great testimonial from a fan in the UK, who's also used a bonker to solve so many problems. Next.
$4.99 top chat from Holden on Dog Training.
Oh, hey, Ashley, how are you?
I have two whiners. I'd rather fix biting, but thanks to you guys, I can stop issues like this. My gratitude toward you is overwhelming. Thank you.
You're welcome. Whiners, man, I'll take a biter most of the time as well. I agree. Yeah. Especially if you can fix it real quick.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Melissa posted the link to the seminars.
Great. And someone asked about the December 5th and 6th seminar. It's not on there yet because it's not booked yet. It's not complete yet. The contract is not signed. So we still have three dates that are open that we haven't put up yet. Ramona being one of them. Next. As soon as we sign the paperwork, it will go up, and we still have a year left. Next.
Well, that's an interesting question. I think I'm going to read it.
Sure.
Mad Dog said, saw your video where you bonked the Great Pyrenees. I noticed that at the moment you bonked the dog, he was actually looking at the owner
right.
And not the other dog.
Right.
Was this intentional? Does it matter?
Okay, so this is what we're actually doing a video on this tomorrow. People keep, and if you watch, and hopefully you watch the whole video too. Okay, the whole video, not just the little clip, but the whole video that we put up. Like, we put this video up. The owner said no. The dog looked up. Yes, but the dog was loading. So we're really fully explaining this. If you watch the whole video, the reason why the owner was at the seminar, she's wheelchair bound now permanently. Like, this was the last week she was able to actually stand up with her cane. After that, she was wheelchair, but she is wheelchair bound. Okay. She specifically came to the seminar because her one-year-old dog started lunging at dogs. The video shows the dog lunging at dogs. And then there's something called loading. Every dog owner and dog trainer needs to understand what loading means. If you truly want to stop a behavior, you need to put an inhibitor in when the dog is thinking about doing that bad behavior. That is the best time to do it. So, the dog was loading. I told her to say no. She said no. The dog looking up at her does not matter whatsoever. And that's what people are making a big, one of the things that people are making a big stink of. Oh, the dog was looking up at her. It doesn't matter. I'm glad that you heard the word no and you're looking up at me. After the word no has to come the punisher. This was the first time it happened. I bonked the dog because she was not strong enough to. Now, if anybody cares, you do. That's why you asked us very respectfully. But if anybody really cared, you would ask this question. Did it work? The answer is, yes, it did. She's in a wheelchair. She has this very large dog, as she should, for mobility. And the dog stopped at that seminar, by the way, right after that, lunging at dogs, not pulling her to the ground. For some reason, people aren't concerned about a human being pulled to the ground or a human being pulled out of a wheelchair. And 2 months later, the dog still has not lunged at a dog. The reason why we show this type of work and we show bonking, because the towel that was used was $1.32 from Walmart. And this is important because it's cheaper than a remote collar. You can buy them anywhere. It stops. I can name 50 behaviors that I can probably tell you that it stops. But it doesn't make a difference if the dog was looking at the human or not. What the dog was doing was loading, we're going to do a whole post on loading, at the other dogs with intent to lunge. The timing on that was a little bit off because I was speaking, but when I deployed the bonker, that was not the bad timing at all. Whether the dog looked at me, her, or kept looking at the dogs does not matter. The timing of her no when it was loading is what matters. It's called a marker, and markers are important. Yes markers, we clicker train, or we use the word yes. No marker, and then we deliver a food reward. No marker, we use the word no, and then we have numerous things that we can use to make a behavior intolerable. The bonker is the most effective when it comes to leash reactivity on numerous dogs, sometimes more effective than a remote collar is. Next.
Alrighty, Bob. When you're board and train, do you work on one command at a time, or throughout the day you teach more than one obedience command?
So when it comes to a board and train, considering that we work with dogs with a lot of problems, a lot of times we're doing parallel training. Sometimes the first couple of days we're just stopping stuff just to stay safe. Barking, lunging, growling, trying to bite us. When it comes to obedience, we start off working one command at a time, unless they're offering other commands. Eventually though, like within a week, you're working on all of them like over the course of the day, and dogs usually get anywhere from 6 to 10 training sessions a day. Next.
Diane, you guys finally look rested and no coughs or colds? No, I don't think so.
I think coughing is gone for you.
Yeah, like as of yesterday.
Yeah. Resting, that could, that's open for discussion. I think calm. Yeah. I'm feeling very calm tonight.
Me too.
I'm feeling very calm. Next. And it could be because I'm exhausted.
Yeah.
Next.
Caitlin, first live I've made. Yay. I've been lurking for months. I was having leash reactivity problems with my service dog in training. Followed your online content and 100% fixed. I have my lifeline back.
Awesome. You see, that's what awesome. Congratulations. And that's what a lot of people are like. They're like, well, if it's a proper service dog, you know, it shouldn't be lunging. It's like, I cannot tell you how many service dogs have started doing unwanted behaviors that are trained or that are in training. That's the power of training. This concept that the dog should be perfect from the minute it gets out of the womb, it doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way at all. Next.
Like, so I want to touch on that, though.
Mm.
I have a one-on-one client who has the most solid...
Oh, yeah,
Great
Dane, yeah.
Her mobility dog.
Yep.
got rushed by an off-leash dog.
Yep, that happens all
Guess what? Became leash reactive. Yep. You're going to wash a dog after 4 years of intense training.
Yep.
When you can fix it.
Yep. That's another big thing.
Why would you do that?
That's another big thing.
So all 4 years of this dog's incredible work is just now, oh, you suck and we can't use you?
Exactly. Yeah, that's what people don't realize, that dogs can start new behaviors because of either age, or they have some discomfort, or a bad experience. And the bad experience is not delivered from a trainer like myself. It's by just another dog or by nature. Next.
Madeline, my dog gets extraordinarily distracted and excited when he sees deer. This is dangerous
during
rut and hunting season, and I do not want him reacting at all these wildlife. How do I stop?
So what you would do is I would start learning how to do remote collar training. So learn how to do remote collar training and learn recall, but also use the remote collar for just general, like, stop, you know, having wandering eyes and focus more on me. Okay. If you happen to like the show, give us a thumbs up. If you don't like the show, give us a thumbs down. And if you haven't joined, join us on Sally Canine Training and turn on your notifications. Next.
Madeline. Oh, I already read that. Mm-hmm. Christine just bonked my dog with a loaf of French bread. Ha.
Nice. Hopefully the French bread wasn't, you know, 2 days old, because then
that shit's hard.
That shit becomes really, really hard. You know what? We've sort of stopped. We've cut down on bread dramatically.
Mm-hmm.
Even back home as a family, Linda and the kids, I think. Well, Angela still has his ham loaf sandwiches and stuff.
I just bought bread today, though. Like, I'm fine with, like, I'll do bread with peanut butter and almond butter all the time, or banana all the time.
Right, right.
My go-to.
Right, or guacamole.
Yeah, like avocado toast.
Avocado toast. You made some of that. Yeah.
I'm not like anti-bread.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely cut down on the bread though. Next.
Yeah. Shannon says hi.
Hello, Shannon. How are you?
Michelle just bought Cool Dog Tricks and the raw feeding ebook you recommended on your site.
Awesome. Thank you. I really, really appreciate it. Yep, and that's cooldogtricks.com. And then if anyone's interested in raw feeding, there's a great ebook on raw feeding. You'll really, really enjoy it. It's from a great, wonderful person. This guy's name is Thomas, and he's just fantastic. Very well informed. Also, unfortunately, if you're struggling with cancer with your dog, he has a lot of research on that. Next.
Dark Warrior, thanks so much, Jeff. He's pretty compliant with commands. I'll keep at it. Thanks again.
Awesome, awesome. Proud of you.
Cassie, is there a honeymoon phase for new puppy? The first 3 days were great, but then he flipped the switch. Coincidentally, the same day he got a booster immunizations. Any correlation?
Yeah, possibly yes, but there is a honeymoon phase for dogs throughout life. Next.
Atmospheric. Hey, J&J, my dog walks good on leash, but she gets reactive when there's another dog around. She doesn't respond to leash corrections. How do I stop this?
Correct. So this is exactly what we're talking about, why we bark. It's like, here's somebody that's like, my dog walks perfectly on a leash, which means your dog knows heel, until. This is what people constantly don't understand. Just train the dog to walk better on a leash.
Mm-hmm.
Atmospheric pressure has done that.
Yeah.
But there's always the until one. That's where Jeff Gellman comes in. How do I stop that? So it's like, how do I stop that? What you want to do is, I would use a remote collar or a bonker, and it's hard to bonk in public. But one of the things you can also start doing is, what's the rest of the day look like? That's, by the way, let's talk about make a blog post on that.
On what?
What's the rest of the day look like? Okay.
Write that down.
What's the rest of the day look like? Melissa, will you just Melissa?
Yeah, because I'm gonna forget. Melissa, I do this every show.
Melissa, just message us on that. What's the rest of the day look like as a topic that we need to do a post on? Thank you. And what I'm saying by that is, are you holding your dog accountable for indoor behaviors as well? Like holding place, holding down, doing your thresholds, in and out of the crates, no barking, no free roaming. Are you actually being demanding of your dog as far as, like, you know, coming in the home, running your dog through some serious commands? So let's do that next.
Cassandra, is your experience that correcting reactivity with an e-collar inhibits early warning signs of reactivity? I've noticed my dog going from 0 to 60 lately, but I'm wondering if I'm just missing signs.
Probably you're missing signs. There's a couple of people out there. A lot of people out there will say, if you get rid of, like, the warning signs, then the dog just goes from 0 to 100 or 0 to 60. There are so many dogs out there that go to 0 to 100 that have never been corrected before. How do we know? We see them every day. So the goal is to get rid of the behavior, and then that's why we also correct it, the warning signs as well. And then the hard work comes in where you teach the wanted stuff. But by just teaching the wanted stuff, FYI, that doesn't get rid of the unwanted stuff. I hope people really realize that. So you have to still put an inhibitor in, or else the dog has no motivation to stop. Next.
$4.99 from Michelle P. Sorry, I think he was going on a rant, so I couldn't read your top chat. She said bonkers for bonkers.
Oh, awesome. Thank you, Michelle P.
Diane, my dog catches in the air, 95% accurate. Oh, when she throws the ball in the snow.
Oh, good. So this is it. Put on some cold weather gear.
Yep.
Get them boots from L.L. Bean or wherever. Get your hat on, get your gloves on, and just get out there and do it. Next.
T.I. said thanks.
Or move to Hawaii.
That's always a good idea, too.
Next.
Kathy, what can they do? They won't find time to come on here, so asking for them. Grr.
Who?
Asking for a friend. I don't know, Kathy's friends.
What is the question?
I don't know. I think we asked it earlier.
Oh, okay, I see. So if they don't have time to come on here, I mean, that's fine. They can also, hopefully they'll hear the answer. Next.
Mad Dog said he clicked on the link, but there isn't a Ramona seminar because we haven't posted it yet.
Yeah, right? we haven't posted yet. Yep, exactly.
T.I. said, thanks, longtime fan. I watch all your vids. When are you coming to the Midwest, Milwaukee?
We're coming to the Chicago area. So, I mean, go to jeffgellmanseminars.com. Next.
Mad Dog said he did watch the entire video. It was good.
Thank you. Good. And it works. And it works. And when I post up that video, I knew there'd be controversy, but the amount of people that it has helped has been incredible. Next.
I think a lot of people struggle with the timing. That it's like you mark the loading with no, and then most dogs, when you say something, they're going to look at you. But it's like you still have to correct them.
Yeah.
It happens all the time, right. But I don't think people understand, right, like, timing.
Right.
Or, so that's why we made a video about it.
Right. Or what they do is they say, oh, well, the dog stopped loading and it looked, so then you don't have to correct. It's like, but yes, you do.
You didn't teach the dog anything.
The dog didn't teach anything. It's like, you could the owner could have said pizza.
Exactly.
And the dog
broccoli.
Would have
looked. It would have been like, what?
Right, exactly. So you have to still put an inhibitor in.
Mm-hmm.
You have to.
Yeah.
I mean, and it's like, this is not our first rodeo. Like, we stop leash reactivity daily. I mean, people come to our... There is a reason why we have 25 dogs doing downstays next to each other at seminars on day two. And it's not because they're afraid of being punished. Some of them might be, as they should. It's only day two of a seminar. Next.
Icy Big Sky. Hey guys, my daughter is a huge fan now. Her pup is almost 4 months and he's crate potty trained and knows basic commands. Thanks for all you guys do. Her dog is very well behaved. Hi Sydney, if you're watching, lol.
Awesome.
Wave Function. 1.5-year-old white GSD. She can heel off and on leash with distractions. Mm-hmm. Very good recall, e-collar trained. Problem is, she's too protective of the family and our other dogs. She doesn't like strangers or dogs.
Okay. So number one, again, what you would do is you would correct that. A lot of people say it was a German Shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a lot of people say, oh, well, that's what German Shepherds do. It's like, okay, if you wanted your German Shepherd to protect the family, yes, but you historically don't, because you'll never get another Amazon package ever again. And I'm being serious here. You'll never get another food delivery again. So what you want to do is a simple remote collar could absolutely stop that with just, you know, dogs being reactive. No, boom. I own German Shepherds and I own a Malinois, and their nature is to be protective, and they're not allowed to be. Next.
Bob, awesome to hear wheelchair-bound lady was able to keep her big dog, thanks to your help, Jeff, rather than her having to surrender it, which wouldn't end well, likely.
No, it wouldn't have, and there's no reason why she couldn't keep it. And this is one of over 3,000 stories of people that have come to our seminars, and these are just two-day seminars, and one of probably over 100,000 results from our free social media. See, this is the thing, is like, people are so, like, how do people think that bad behaviors are stopped? People see a dog, they hear the history of the dog on our website, They're all excited because they know the dog will do well. They see the dog do well and they enjoy that. But are we interested in what happened, how we got from A to B? Because if you pay attention, you can do it too. But the reason why I think so many people are struggling with badly behaved dogs, because they don't want to do what it takes to actually stop the unwanted behavior. And that's not due to laziness, it's due to social media pressure. So we will continue to show our work. We will continue to, I don't want to have too many weeks like I've had this week because it's been a living hell, but we will continue to take the heat and take the slack. And if other dog trainers want to not put it out there, that's on them. But what's also keep in mind, this whole bonking thing, I personally know 100 dog trainers, personally, like literally personally, that are bonking. There must be 1,000. Tens of thousands of owners are doing it. People have been throwing shit at their dogs for years. How many of you have said, your dog's barking at the front window, how many of you have just grabbed a throw pillow and said, shut the hell up, and thrown it at the dog? Come on, guys.
Yeah.
Let's be practical here. Next.
My boy. How many people have accidentally hit their dog with a truck?
Oh, my God.
Almost every day, Wes will he'll project the freaking throw, be right in the way, clocks him in the head, and he's like, oh my God, this is the best thing ever.
Or when you run, so sometimes...
And I whip that chocolate ball.
So sometimes we'll run 5 dogs at the same time, our personal dogs.
Smash into each other.
And it's like, you're throwing the ball, and a dog, like, runs in front of it. And like, sometimes, like, literally...
Birds barrel rolled across the freaking pavement before.
So sometimes, like, right in front of you, it's like... Like, this was going, like, way downrange, and you happen to, like, run in front of it. It's like, you know, and you can hear it go thump, and it's like, gosh, that must have really hurt. You know what they do? They chase the ball. They don't care.
Nope.
Next.
My boy, I finally stopped using the nylon slip lead leash and bought a new prong collar that you recommended. Been watching all your prong collar training videos, and it's worked out great. Our walks are thumbs up.
Awesome. I think it's really important to understand that... Yes, a lot of dog trainers can be, they can work on slip leads. But this is the thing. Man, the prong collar is one of the best tools out there as well. Next.
Will, I'm a big fan of the training center videos. I can watch you guys training dogs for hours. Any chance we'll get to see them more frequently?
Yeah, I mean, this is the thing is okay, keep in mind, all this free content, I mean, I'm not saying this for ego, even though people think, because my ego is stoked through owner success, but all this free content that we put up, it's $100,000 a year in payroll that I pay. Like, I have to pay people to put this content up. Like, so I pay people to take the video, I pay people to edit it. Edit, I mean by time. Then there's time to put it up, there's time to write the narrative, then there's time to monitor the questions. There's time to delete a lot of questions, delete a lot of stuff. That's actually been a 4-person job lately. And then there's time to answer questions. And a lot of these questions we can't answer. We just send people to the show. So the reason why we don't show as much training center stuff is because a lot of people want to know how to stop stuff. That's why. But yes, that video.
Okay, so January, February, we're pretty much home. We're going to do a lot more of our how-to series and remake a lot of those. So
yes,
you'll be seeing more of us, training and, all that stuff. Right. Yes.
And that's not because we don't want to be showing the correction stuff. It's because it's, we're going to be there more.
We have time.
Remember? And then also we have to also keep in mind, some of our staff just doesn't want to be on video.
Yeah.
They're just they're not on video. And this is what our goal is. These are clients' dogs. If we're filming a staff member and they're uncomfortable because maybe they're worried about their appearance or their timing or the way they might look on camera, we have to be respectful towards our staff members. Mm-hmm. They have a job to do. They've got a job. So a lot of people don't want to be on video. So, but we're doing. I think we're putting out more content than I don't want to say anyone on the internet, but I think today we put up at least 6 to 8 posts.
Daily, we've been getting between, like, 6 to 8.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a lot of posts to put up.
But maybe we can start doing more, like, lives.
Yeah, and then also, we're doing a live 90-minute show tonight. So just think about that. Just think about how much count that is and how much content that takes and how there's no art and how there's it's all free. And then it's all free. And I'm not looking for any, like, apologies or kudos right now. What I'm saying is, like, we also have a business to run. You know, I mean, I do own a company with a large payroll and large expenses. So I just like to, you know, I like to put it out there that it's like, you know, there's owning a business is very expensive. Next.
Cassandra, I'm hearing about the woman whose dog was bonked and stopped lunging after one correction. How come I've corrected my dog multiple times and he's still a jerk? I'm coming to your reactivity class.
So I would absolutely recommend you sign up for that reactivity class.
Yeah.
What's your name, Sandra?
Cassandra.
Cassandra. Cassandra or Cassandra, chances are your timing is off or your oomph is not hard enough, but you're only going to look, that's only one thing. If you come to the leash reactivity class, we will show you everything we have, nothing held back. I would highly recommend that. It's a very special class. This is the only time we've done it. It goes over 2 weeks. Joelle and myself are teaching it. You're getting me, you're getting Joelle, which you normally don't get at the training center. Other than on a board and train, you get Joelle, but on a one-on-one, you don't get that. So I would highly recommend that. Your dog will stop being reactive. Next.
Mad Dog. I'm not making a stink. I'm just trying to learn as much as I can. I love the video. Ah, you just mentioned your timing. I saw that. You were correcting the loading, not enforcing the no command. Got it. Yeah, the dog didn't even know what no was.
Like, right. We're teaching it. So who's that, Mad Dog? Mm-hmm. But actually, it's not about... let me just talk about that a little bit. So enforcing it, we were teaching the no command. So in other words, if you clicker train, when you want to start teaching the dog with a clicker means, what do you do? Click food, click food, click food, click food, click food, click food, click food. The dog, what are you clicking for? Nothing. I'm just teaching what the click means. With no, you're doing also the same thing. No consequence. No consequence. Now you have to be more careful with no. You don't want to just randomly say no to your dog. But you can click food, click food, click food, click food, click food, for the dog just standing there. Okay, but with no, so you're, it's not that we were absolutely not enforcing no, but we did teach that dog what no meant, and no now has very, very powerful meaning. Yeah. That's exactly how you teach no, and you don't do it. Think about an alcoholic. You don't have a conversation with your alcoholic friend when they're plastered, like sleeping on the bar. You have a conversation with them the next morning when they're more open to receive information. So it's the same thing with dog training, something that a lot of folks for some reason are not grasping, and so we need to do a better job of explaining it, obviously. But and then for all those people out there that they don't care whatsoever, they're under the guise that you should never correct a dog, so it doesn't matter anyway. But there are folks like you who actually want to learn, and that's who we care about. Next.
Brits, I love my walks now. I have not struggled leaving my house since the prong collar. 2 full months, loving the walk.
Awesome. Proud of you. Proud of you.
Cassandra, how long are each of the training sessions for your board and train dogs?
The Cassandra, they differ. They could be a 5-minute session,
yeah,
a 20-minute session, a 30-minute session, a 60-minute session, but also it could be a 4-hour session. There might be a dog in place for 4 hours. We can have a dog in its kennel lying down with its head down for 4 hours while a lot of other activity goes on. That actually is training. We can be doing active training or inactive training. They're theoretically always training. They're not allowed to whine. They're not allowed to bark. They're not allowed to stand up in their crates. They can't be spinning around. They can't be doing any OCD behaviors. So there's a lot of different things. But as far as like active, like trainer has the leash or trainer's giving a command, that can be anywhere for 10 minutes to 40 minutes. Excuse me,
yawning.
Next, sorry.
Mad Dog said, I fucking love you guys, no filter way of speaking. How did I not find your video sooner?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's probably...
Did you find us in the swarm of hate?
Yeah.
Just curious.
Yeah, I think a lot of times my no filter is my biggest asset, but also I don't look at it as, it's the thing that gets me probably in the most trouble.
Does it get you in trouble?
It gets me in the most trouble. And I think, though, that I think that people need to hear the truth.
Yeah.
And I think, you know what, one of the things that we're getting a lot of stuff will be coming out in the next couple days about this video and about the hate that's coming out and who's responsible for it. I think it's just not my nature, but at this point I need to do something. I think it's important that trainers start at least talking about it. You don't have to show it, but at least talking about, like, how do we stop unwanted behaviors? I think it's really, really important. I think it's important because that's what owners need.
Yeah.
I mean, owners don't need another how to teach a dog sit class.
Mm-hmm.
They just don't need that. I'm sorry. They don't.
No.
It's really easy to do. Like, teaching your dog to sit is easy.
All basic obedience.
Hold something up above its nose. Wait till it does it. Mark it. Eventually, after half a dozen reps, give it a name. Continue to mark it. Reinforce it. Do variable marking. And then after 500 times, 400 times, if the dog doesn't do it, learn to apply a correction for noncompliance of a behavior that it should know. I mean, it's a really simple concept. It's a formula. So, you know, find the motivator. And sometimes if they're not food motivated, leash pressure might have to be the motivator. Next.
$9.99 top chat from my boy. He said, thank you.
You're welcome.
Caitlin, major pet peeve. Same situation as the Great Dane. My pup was attacked a service dog meetup, ironically. Oh my God. I was trying to find help to fix the situation and constantly got shit on to wash my pup. I've already put in over 2 years of training.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think this is the thing, is like, it's so easy to say that. It's really unempathetic, too.
Mm-hmm.
Unempathetic, inempathetic, unempathetic.
Unempathetic.
Yeah, it's not empathetic. Okay. Someone's being a real dick to say that to you. They don't walk in your shoes, and, you know, you can get a dog that is wonderful, but all of a sudden it gets attacked on a leash, it becomes leash reactive. It's a very, very common thing. There's dogs that all of a sudden have been going up and down steps for years, but all of a sudden they miss a step and they slide down the steps, and all of a sudden they become afraid of the steps.
Mm-hmm.
It's like literally like that, just like that. So I had a dog, Max, who's no longer with me, who is eating out of a metal food bowl. His dog tags, the little ring that hold dog tags that are connected to the D-ring, for some reason got caught on the bowl. When he lifted his head up, the bowl crashed to the ground. For a week, he wouldn't eat out of that bowl. He became paranoid. So, I mean, you know, and that was just, I was in the other room. It just happened. I just heard the noise. And I saw the dog food all over the floor. This is before I was serving raw. This goes back quite a few years. And it's like, I worked him through it. But I'm just saying, though, anything can happen at any time. At any time. I mean, you can get in your first car accident after 40 years of driving, and then all of a sudden, like, be really afraid to drive.
Yeah.
I mean, there's so many variables out there in life that, like, sometimes we can't control. And to say to somebody, oh, well, then you should get rid of the dog or wash the dog or stop doing this or stop doing that. It's like, or there is another option, work the dog through it. Next.
Or shouldn't own that breed.
Right.
Like, any freaking dog can become leash reactive.
Well, I've seen, I mean, I'm seeing, own that breed. I'm seeing 30-pound dogs pull their owners down the street.
We had a little tiny dog lunging out the window of a car at us today. It's like any dog can do that.
Yeah, we were at
Trader Joe's.
Was it Trader Joe's? Yeah, we were at the Trader Joe's parking lot, and there was two dogs, you know, and dogs are in cars. It's fine. It's not 100 degrees outside. And they were barking. And that's one. It's like, of course you're barking. We're standing right next to you. But I looked at this dog, and I said, that's a different type of bark. That's a bark, I would never do this. But that's a bark that if that door opened up, it would bite me.
100%.
And there was a dog right behind it who was like, that dog wouldn't. You know what I mean? It's like two dogs in the same car. I absolutely knew that that dog would bite me. And there's another dog in the car that I would be like, that dog won't. Why? It's because I understand dogs. I understand dogs. So I think it's like these dogs are what, less than 20 pounds?
Yeah, I was tiny.
They were small, like a 13-pound dog. But guess what, though? I wouldn't want it to bite a child. I wouldn't want it to bite me, but I sure as heck wouldn't want it to bite a child. Next.
$4.99 top chat from Michelle. Everyone just says there are other ways to stop behavior. Reward for something else, and maybe eventually, after a ton of time, they might stop.
So, you know, one of the things is this, is if somebody wants to say there's other ways to do it, first of all, I agree, there are other ways. There's a lot of ways. But number one, show me. Don't just say it. But number two, who cares? This way also works. Who's to say one way is better than another way? But teaching an alternative behavior will not stop the behavior you're trying to get rid of. People, please need to understand this. You need to instill an inhibitor. And then, of course, you teach what you want with a dog. That's what we do as well. Next.
$4.99 top chat from the Noble Dog.
Oh, hey, Grant. How are you, buddy?
What is your crate training protocol for puppies? Just set them in the crate? What are your thoughts on harnesses for dogs less than 10 pounds?
If you want to use a harness on a dog less than 10 pounds and it works for you, you absolutely do it. People can use any training tool they want. That's fine. That's fine. But for someone to say this is better than this, I mean, who's to decide that? It's like, what's the most effective? What's the most effective? So as far as the crate training protocol for puppies, it's like you put them on a schedule and you stick to it. It all depends on their age, what the schedule would be. Next.
Christine said, the bread was still soft and it's a treat for me. French bread, French loaf. Good bread.
When you go to an actual bakery,
oh yeah,
you only have a day to eat that
it's
bread.
It's like a pillow. It's just like, but it's little like.
But since historically there's no preservatives in there,
it's so good.
You don't have much time.
No.
You don't have much time.
Like a nice fresh loaf of sourdough.
Yes. Well, you probably won't eat this now, but you ever get the Portuguese sweet bread?
Oh yeah.
With the raisins.
So good.
You don't like it with the raisins, but
I like
good.
Portuguese sweet bread.
You can get it without the raisins.
What's that other bread that we brought back?
Brioche.
No, we brought it back for like everybody. Where were we? We found it in that super the food store. We brought back like a ton of like they were like circular and had like olives and cheese and like all these different.
Oh.
Not ciabatta, but it was like a weird name like that.
I remember that.
It was so fluffy.
We saw that it was in a grocery store.
Mm-hmm.
It was in a Wegmans.
Was it in like North Dakota or something?
It might have been in a Wegmans. Yep. In fact, no, the night before we took photos of it, and we'll go, oh, we'll pick them up tomorrow. We got there the next day.
And my whole freaking thing smelled like cheesy garlic bread.
But they didn't have as many.
Yeah, agreed.
Yep.
Paul, my GSD has an umbilical hernia. He's a year old. How soon should he get operated?
I don't know. That's a vet question. Next.
Mad Dog, how much does it cost to host one of your seminars? I own a dog daycare in San Diego. No, it's not one of those places where the dogs run amok and act crazy. We are the calmest off-leash daycare in the U.S.
So, it doesn't cost you anything. What you do is you get lots of business afterwards and before and during. What you can do is you can go to Jeff Gellman Seminars. There should be a link on I Want to Host, and you actually can apply to be a host, and then I'll absolutely talk to you. And congratulations on your success. Next.
Ron, interested in dog training as a career, have explored local and non-local options. Any specific advice for entering the field? Have been volunteering at a shelter to help and also learn day in and day out.
What I would do is I would do an internship. You know, this is the thing, is that people pay lots of money to go to university and to go to college, and historically you get drunk, stoned, and laid a lot, but what do you actually learn for $20,000 to $40,000 a year? Or what you can do is you can do an internship with a company for 3 months or a year and live off that money you would pay for school, and you'll probably actually end up learning more stuff. And I think eventually what you're going to be doing is you're going to be paying employers to actually work there, which sounds really, really far-fetched. But, I mean, if you wanted to, I mean, and we're not talking about, like, becoming a brain surgeon or maybe a lawyer, things like that, but you actually, there's people that learn, get law degrees on their own by reading books. I mean, prisoners in jail are getting law degrees. So I think...
I sort of paid you to work for you.
Yeah, Yeah.
I like went to T3 and I went to a seminar.
Yep. So.
Like I'll find a way.
What I would do is I would look for an internship with somebody next.
Jem, after 2 months of positive training only with a 3-year-old Doberman rescue, I almost gave up on him. Then I bonked him with a pillow. No more issues since then. He's been great. Thank you.
Yeah. Think about that. 2 months of hell that could have been eliminated way earlier. So I'm glad you found a solution. Next.
Brooklyn, any seminars in Arizona?
We're looking for a location in the Phoenix and Tucson area, but nothing, and we would be doing that in, most likely December of 2020. Next.
Kathy, daughter's 6-month-old golden doodle was free roaming. Yes, I know, ate garlic, and while that was making him puke, also found he ate a sock. Yes. Now they want to go back to crating, but the dog goes nuts, tears the crate up.
Well, get rid of any bedding in the crate, and then you can actually bonk the crate, shake the crate, pick up the crate, and do, you know, shaking of the crate, remote collar, so you can get a dog to lie down in a crate in a matter of seconds and be calm. Next.
Monk, canine, how do you find balance? My friends and family call me obsessive about training. Thanks.
Balance in life?
I think just dog training, maybe.
I mean, this is the thing. I mean, I'm not one of these, like, always dog training people. I mean, I only train dogs when I'm at seminars. So I think this concept of, like, it's important to find balance in life, just for me, like, I don't have balance in life. I never will have balance in life. But then again, what does balance in life mean? Well, you need to have a healthy balance between work and home. Okay, what percentage is that? And who's to say? Next.
Debbie, is the bonker and an e-collar equally effective, or does it depend on the situation? I don't always have a bonker in hand while walking the neighborhood, but we always have the e-collar on.
Right. You can bonk at the beginning of the walk, and then you're instilling a no inhibitor, and then the remote collar takes over from there historically. Next.
Wave function. Thanks for the response, Jeff. I love the channel. Cheers from New Zealand.
Oh, hey, New Zealand. I'll be in New Zealand also. If you check, I'm Jeff Gellman Seminars. Next.
T.I., how do I stop my dog, my beagle, to stop chewing his bed? I've gone through 15 of them. I'm not buying anymore until he learns how.
Okay. So I suggest your beagle does not have a bed. Okay? You'd have to catch the dog in the act. We'd use a remote collar. You'd make it suck to eat the bed, okay? And then, but now, are you willing to leave for 4 hours? Next.
Jared, after Skyping, my wife was able to take the kids today and go out and come back, and the dog did not whine in the crate when she left or when she came home.
Awesome.
The e-collar is working. Thanks for all you do.
Awesome, awesome. Really proud of you. Good job. Good job. And we do Skypes. I do a lot of Skypes. Next.
Ryan, how would you train a puppy that is getting collar-wise? An example, understands the collar has consequences and behaves differently when it's off versus on. More use of the bonker?
Well, how long have you been doing the training for? Has the dog gotten up to correction level? Have you done months and months and months, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of reps? Are you putting the collar on in the morning, rotating it throughout the day, and taking the collar off at night? I have no idea what your training protocol looks like. Next.
Andy, a throw pillow works wonders if you don't have a bonker. It worked for me.
Yep, shoes. There was somebody at one of my seminars who actually just was so frustrated with his dog making noise in the crate. He took off his shoe and said no and threw it at the crate. That worked fine. Next.
John, when teaching sit as an implied stay, does the dog still understand he is obeying a command as you increase time duration, or do they forget they are in a sit stay?
All depends on how well your markers are, your training is, your repetition, making sure the dog's got clear information. Your timing on the breaking of the command is proper. They know, especially if you're working on one command at a time.
Mm-hmm. $4.99 top chat from Kathy. Thank you so much for all the free content, your commitment and loyalty to help us.
Oh, my pleasure. My pleasure. Thanks for recognizing that. I really mean it. Thanks for recognizing that. So, next.
The pooped puppy wanted to let you know that watching you has given me the confidence to convince my clients to use punishment instead of beating the bush.
Well, they were beating some, yeah, beating the bush, or you beating around the bush. Beating around the bush. Yeah, I think that, you know, this is the thing. First of all, congratulations. What's also happening out there in the dog training world is there's a lot of dog trainers. I'm not saying this is you, poop puppy. A lot of dog trainers are spouting, don't use punishment. This wasn't you, but they're saying, don't use punishment, but then they're going home and using punishment on their own dogs to stop unwanted behaviors. That's a little bit hypocritical. Next.
Cassandra, are you still looking for a social media intern?
Are you? I think you're trying somebody new out today.
Yeah.
So
I'm just like...
So what we've done is we found one, and we're happy with her.
Yeah, she's great.
Yep, we're happy with her. Maddie, we love you. And then this morning at the gym, actually. So, hoorah, Planet Fitness. Thank you for being around the country.
Mm-hmm.
The gym this morning, we actually sort of semi-hired somebody at the gym, and I think you've talked to her since then, mm-hmm. right? So I think we're testing out another one today. We might be all set, but stay in touch. Stay in touch.
I just saw Keaton's thing pop up. Spanish bonger equals a chancla. It's so true. It's like your slipper, like your little like sandal.
It's true. Yes.
Chancla.
That's right.
We'll just start calling it that.
Yeah.
We don't bong dong, we chancla.
Yes.
The pooped puppy. I've always used it on my dogs, but was reserved to teach my clients to use hard aversives. Now I don't care. I tell them what they need to hear instead of what they want. It's hard here in soft-ass California.
Well, the poop puppy, I travel the world, okay? You will attract people that want to hear the message. So right now, you know, what's going on right now in social media against me right now is going to be a very interesting outcome. And... what's going to happen is the truth will always win. Okay, number one. More people are realizing that how important that punishment is. And I'm also on a mission. I mean, it's one thing to yell and scream about dogs. It's another thing to actually be in the trenches saving their lives. It's one thing to rescue a dog, and that's not a disservice, thank you so much, but it's another thing to train and rehab them. So, you know, you saving a dog from a death sentence, you know, did you grow your wings? Okay, well, now what are you going to do with it? So we have a lot of rescues that will contact us saying, we've got 4 dogs that have get into dog fights every day. We just pulled them last week. Will you please train them for free? The answer is no. We do train for free, but that's not how we train. That's not that. That conversation is no. Second of all, if you're going to be pulling aggressive dogs, no disrespect, you better have resources to fix those dogs, or do not pull them. A wonderful, wonderful rescue dog on Seattle, who just, hosted us in Seattle this past weekend. They're a great example of someone who can pull dogs, but they have a network of trainers and fosters who can actually rehab them.
Yep.
And then there are people out there that don't know the first thing about even getting a dog to walk on a leash, who are pulling highly aggressive dogs. And they might think they're doing the dog a service, and I'm not saying the dog should have died, but what I'm saying is you can't save them all, and who's going to rehab it? Who? And then where does the dog go afterwards? You need to have these things in place. Next.
$5 top chat from Corey. Jeff, you helped save my dog's life. Thank you, thank you, thank you. ABC College taught me how to train new commands. You taught me how to save a life. I rehab, rehome now. Thank you.
Awesome. I'm proud of you. Next.
That's awesome. Diane, I see your various posts on Instagram each day and keeps me informed.
Awesome. Good.
Melissa posted the link to our reactive dog training class.
Oh, thank you. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Mac, prong collars are great. I have a bum arm and can't walk both dogs, 60 pounds each, without a problem. Oh, I can walk them.
Right.
I'm in control, not them. If people have a problem with it, oh well, that's their issue, not mine. Healthy, happy, and content. Thanks, Jeff, for enforcing that idea that prong collars are not evil.
Yeah, I think that, well, kudos to you, number one. Sorry about your arm. But I think it's really important that people realize that it's like this human's quality of life is better. So a lot of people are like, trust me, we're always concerned about the dog. That's why we do the work we do. We're trying to keep them alive and expand their world with their owners. But how about the human's quality of life? That's the next. Sorry.
Oh.
Sorry.
Sid. Hi, J&J. Find it frustrating when owners deal with do not want to correct their dogs for bad behaviors. Where are the clients who truly want to change their dogs, not finding them?
Well, this is it. Number one, take 100% responsibility. You let those clients in. Don't be one of these dog trainers that complains about the clients. I'm not saying right now. I'm just saying that's a common mm-hmm. thread. Also, I think what you need to do is if you start putting your work out there, explaining what you do, maybe showing or talking about what you do, you're going to get those people. Next.
It's Zims. My 10-pound chihuahua knocked me down when a truck rumbled by and scared her. She ran underfoot. Crash. I landed on my face.
Yep. 10-pound dog. Also, put all that information on your website and pre-screen your clients to make sure that they'll be willing to correct their dogs before you let them in the door. Next.
Cassandra, when you say dogs are leash reactive, does that mean they're completely fine off-leash? My dog will chase dogs away off-leash, is never off-leash anymore, but I want to come to the reactivity class.
Chances are your dog is leash reactive. So what you can do, the thing is this is, if you leash reactive is, okay, if your dog's off leash, it can't be leash reactive because it's not on a leash. But if it was on a leash, what would it do? It would most likely be reactive. If not, the class can still benefit you if you've got a dog that's like growling, barking, chasing other dogs. Next.
Or just can't walk nicely on a leash. We'll show you how to clean up your heel and
right,
stuff, too.
Right.
Keaton. Well, guys, I got him to stop whining in the moment while crated. I cracked the crate. Bought a new one today. Haha, 10-week-old Dutchie. Also, how do you make all dogs at the training facility quiet? E-collar and bark collars?
It's possible that the first day they're there, they might have to get a remote collar, a bark collar, or a remote collar on. But pretty much, it turns into just expected behavior. We get them to be quiet through application of proper, punishments. They're not afraid. They're very content lying down. Next.
Astrid, hi Jeff. I attended your seminar in Reno. With your advice and training during the seminar, my German Shepherd had a huge turnaround. Awesome. Thank you for everything you've taught me and my dog.
Awesome. Yeah, seminars are powerful.
They really are.
And they're also a lot of fun.
That was a good one.
You know, another thing that people like commented about that one video is about like, oh, everybody's laughing. They're laughing not at the dog being bonked.
No, someone made a joke. The owner was standing right next to me.
The owner also said something too.
It was the woman, so she was just at our seminar in Seattle.
Okay.
She was in Vegas, and she's the one who had the dog doing the pass by.
Oh, right.
And she's like, that's going to be you next or something. Right. And she was right next to the camera as I was filming.
Yeah, so I think it's important.
Context.
I think it's important that like nobody's laughing at a dog being bonked or corrected. I mean, people just don't do that at our seminars. Next. No.
Cedarman, I just got a new client because of the confidence your videos have given me. First meeting and they are making bonkers for counter surfing and whining in the crate for starters. Sent bonking how-to video.
Awesome. Proud of you.
King, how do you use a prong collar when using a back tie for door rushing? Oh, do you use a prong collar? Not how, but do you use a prong collar when using a back tie for door?
For door rushing?
If you have a dog back tied to place or something, yeah, they'd be on a prong.
They'd be on a prong, yeah. Yep, they'd have a prong.
Bob.
But keep in mind, they've already been introduced to the prong and worked on the prong, so they know what it is.
Yeah.
Next.
Bob, haha, that lady bonking her dog with French bread, she broke bread with her dog, lol. Okay. Dog is probably like, oh, a snack just fell out of the sky.
Is that Bob M?
Yeah.
Only you, Bob.
Bob's full of jokes.
Only you.
KJ, escaping crate, high correction works for 5 to 10 minutes before he tries again. Go up to higher level or continue to stay consistent and work over time. How long before he should be able to be left home? 4 hours or so.
Okay, so yes to both, but 4 hours. How old's the dog? Does it say?
No.
Okay, so I mean, if your dog is above 4, 5 to 6 months old, there's no reason why it can't happen in a relatively quick fashion, like a day or two. Next.
John, do you plan on coming back to Chicago?
Yeah, it's already on the schedule. The Chicago seminar actually is on the schedule. If you go to jeffgelmanseminars.com, you can actually buy a ticket there. Also, will be in Elkhart, Indiana. Next.
Bob said it's Calabrese bread, Joelle. I don't think that's what it was called. There's too many kinds of bread.
I think this was in North Dakota.
I'm not the bread connoisseur.
I think this was in North Dakota. Maybe not. I remember that.
You know what bread's good, though? Man, Trader Joe's made this one. It's like a walnut cranberry.
Yes. But you know what's also really good?
So good.
Linda has been buying a raisin bread.
Are you hot?
No.
I'm pretty hot in this sweater.
You're wearing a sweater.
Sweating.
Yeah. There's also the heat. One of the heaters is off. Oh. So, it's not like your typical, like, Pepperidge Farm raisin.
Yeah.
It's like, it oozes. Like, I think it's not just raisins in there. It's like...
Is it like this melted cinnamon
yes,
stuff?
Yes, yes, oh, yes. So, you know what it is? Duh, it's cinnamon raisin.
Cinnamon raisin
but
bread.
But it's like from the bakery.
Yeah.
Not like...
It's like cinnamon swirls, yeah, like but it, the
but,
good shit.
But you take it out and you like, you get your hands get a little sticky. Bit sticky, yes. Mm. Like a glazed donut, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
good.
Yeah.
Are you guys hungry yet?
We are.
The poop...
I think we are.
I'm just like sweating. I'm like dying in here. Joelle's overheating, thinking
yes.
about bread.
That's right.
The pooped puppy. I sent you a long message on IG. Could you read it on here? We'll read it later.
We'll read it later. Next.
Cobri, my GSD is good on recall while on a long line, but ignores me when he's not on a leash. Wondering if my expectations are too high for recall for 6 months. It's like he's making a choice not to recall.
Then you have to get up to punishment level for lack of compliance. Also, how many reps have you done, and are you doing remote collar? But how many reps have you done? Also, what are the environmentals? Next.
Dakota and Blessing. Hi, J&J.
Can just say Blessing.
Oh, yeah, right. Blessing.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yep.
How do I teach my dog to create space if he's uncomfortable when socializing?
What you do is you do it's a twofold thing. Dog's on a leash, stockyard whip, you move the other dogs away, and you gently guide your dog backwards.